history of plant pathology. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to explain the evolution of pathogens, describe the history of plant pathology. The science of plant pathology originated when the human race began the practice of crop cultivation about 4,000 years ago. Ancient Indian literature has recorded the occurrence of plant diseases and the protective measures followed by people, which included the use of organic materials such as turmeric, cow's milk, ghee, animal dung and flesh. Moreover, symptoms of plant diseases were also found in the Old Testament of the Holy Bible and Shakespeare's writings. Later, the Greek philosopher Theophrastus, who lived between 370 and 286 BC, wrote a book named Inquiry into Plants, in which he had shared his experiences with some of the plant diseases. He is regarded as father of botany. After Theophrastus, until Renaissance, that is between 1300 and 1500 AD, there was no significant record of intellectual activity. This period was also called as the Dark Age in the history of plant pathology. Let us now discuss the history of plant pathology in different eras. Pre-modern era, 1600 to 1853. In 1665, Robert Hooke, an English natural philosopher, illustrated a fungal disease, rose rust. In 1675, Anton van Leeuwenhoek, a Dutch businessman and scientist, invented the microscope, and in 1683, he described animalcules with the help of microscope. In 1749, John Turberville Needham, an English biologist, observed the appearance of organisms and concluded that microorganisms originated from non-living matter. He strongly supported the theory of spontaneous generation. In 1729, Pier Antonio Micheli, an Italian botanist, wrote a book named Nova Plantarum Genera and laid the foundation for studying fungi. He was also regarded as the father of mycology. In 1753, Swedish naturalist Carolus Linnaeus wrote a book entitled Species Plantarum and established the binomial system of nomenclature. In 1755, Matthew Tillet, a French scientist, published a paper on bunt or stinking smut of wheat and suggested that the disease incidence can be reduced by rubbing the seeds with salt and lime before sowing. After 52 years, a critical step was taken by a French botanist, Isaac Benedict Prévost, in studying the life cycle of bunt fungus in wheat. His work was confirmed in 1847 by the Toulas brothers. Further, in 1821, Elias Magnus Price published the book Systema Mycologicum, which served as the beginning of nomenclature for fungi. He was regarded as the Linnaeus of mycology. In 1845, the late blight disease devastated the potato crops in Ireland and other parts of Europe, which prompted the mycologists and plant pathologists to conduct a study on plant diseases of potato. During 1889 to 1893, Sir George Watt, a Scottish physician and botanist, gave a detailed description of the disorders of crops in his book with 9 volumes named as Dictionary of Economic Products of India. The foundation of modern experimental plant pathology was laid by the German scientist Heinrich Anton de Bary. In 1861, he experimentally proved that Phytophthora infestans was the cause of late blight disease in potatoes. Further, he made an extensive study on fungal diseases and wrote the book Morphology and Physiology of Fungi Lichen and Myxomycetes. The term symbiosis was also coined by Heinrich. He was regarded as founder or father of plant pathology. In 1859, the theory of spontaneous generation was finally disproved by Louis Pasteur, a French biologist, and this changed the way of thinking of scientists. In 1876, Robert Koch, a German bacteriologist, explained the necessary steps required for an organism to cause an infectious disease known as Koch's postulates. In 1882, Thomas Jonathan Burrell of USA first reported the fire blight disease of apple and pear, which was caused by a bacterium currently known as Erwinia amylovera. Adolf Edward Meyer, a German agricultural chemist, was the first to study the tobacco mosaic virus in 1886. In 1885, Pierre-Marie Alexis Miletet, a French botanist, accidentally discovered the Bordeaux mixture that controlled downy mildew in grape wine, and Albert Bernhard Frank, a German botanist, defined and named mycorrhizal in plant roots the same year. In 1887, Burgundy mixture was introduced to control fungal diseases by Mason of France. In 1895, Erwin Frank Smith of USA gave the final proof of the fact that bacteria could be incidents of plant diseases. He also worked on the bacterial wilt of cucurbits and crown gall disease. Smith was regarded as the father of phytobacteriology for his discoveries and methodologies. Later, in 1898, Martinus Willem Bijernik, a Dutch microbiologist, proved that the tobacco mosaic disease was caused by an organism, Contagium vivum fluidum, which was later regarded as a virus. He was called as the father of plant virology. In 1904, Albert Francis Blaxley, an American geneticist, identified heterothallism in rhizopus. During 1912, Hans Edmund Nicola Berjeff reported the fusion of dissimilar nuclei within the cells of a fungus. He called this phenomenon heterokaryosis. During 1913 to 1932, Nathan Augustus Cobb of USA coined the term NEMA and described hundreds of nematodes. He was regarded as the father of nematology. In 1934, W. H. Tisdale and I. Williams studied the organic fungicides by discovering alkyl dithiocarbamates. In 1943, A. E. Diamond, J. W. Heuberger, and James Gordon Horsfall discovered ethylene bis dithiocarbamate fungicides. In 1945, Horsfall explored the mechanism of fungicidal action. In 1946, Wendell Meredith Stanley, an American biochemist, was awarded the Nobel Prize for his study on the nature of viruses. In 1952, Joshua Lederberg, an American molecular biologist, coined the term plasmid. He won the Nobel Prize for discovering bacterial conjugation along with Edward Laurie Tatum and George Wells Beadle. In the same year, Selman Abraham Waksman, Jewish-American inventor, won the Nobel Prize for the discovery of streptomycin. In 1967, Theodore Otto Diener and William Benton Raymer, American plant pathologists, identified that the potato spindle disease was caused by small, single-stranded circular molecules of infectious RNA known as the viroids. In 1967, Japanese scientists Doi and Ishii independently observed and reported mycoplasma-like organisms, MLOs, now called as phytoplasma, in the phloem of plants exhibiting yellow and witch's broom symptoms. In 1974, I. Zenon and his co-workers demonstrated TI plasmid, in Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Let us conclude the topic by discussing the history of plant pathology in India. The study of fungi in India was initiated by the Europeans in the 19th century. Indians collected the fungi and sent the specimens for identification to the laboratories in Europe. During 1850 to 1875, David Douglas Cunningham and A. Barclay initiated the identification of fungi in India and made a special study on rusts and smuts of leaves. Edwin John Butler, who is also known as the father of Indian plant pathology, initiated an exhaustive study on fungal diseases in 1901 at the Imperial Agricultural Research Institute at Pusa, Bihar. He also wrote a monograph on Pithiaceous and allied fungi, as well as a classic textbook named Fungi and Disease in Plants in 1918. J. F. Daster, a colleague of Butler, was the first plant pathologist in India to carry out a detailed study on fungal diseases of plants. In 1939, B. B. Mankar began to work on the control measures of cotton wilt through varietal resistance. He also identified and classified several Indian smut fungi. Later on, in 1940, Dr. K.C. Mehta of Agra College investigated the life cycle of cereal rusts. G.S. Kulkarni, 1886 to 1971, published comprehensive information on downy mildew and smuts of sugarcane and pearl millet. In 1943, Helminthosporium oryzae species, the causative organism for the Great Bengal Famine, resulted in the death of 2 million people, drew the attention of several plant pathologists. T.S. Sadasivan, in 1944, studied the mechanism of wilting in cotton that was caused by Fusarium oxysporum. In 1948, he initiated a journal by the name Indian Phytopathology and also authored a textbook entitled Fungi and Plant Diseases. S. N. Dasgupta, in 1950, carried out an exhaustive study on black tip of mango and derived the mechanism of vivotoxins. In 1953, Luthra and Satter developed the solar heat treatment of wheat seeds to control loose smut disease. M. J. Tirumalachar, in 1967, conducted exhaustive studies on rusts and smuts and developed a number of antibiotics such as hemicin, dermastatin and oreofungin, MYC4, for controlling plant diseases in India. M. K. Patel, 1949, V. P. Bide, 1949 and G. Rangaswamy, 1972, made tremendous contributions to bacterial plant pathogens. The contributions by various scientists to the field of plant pathology had encouraged the universities of India to include it as a separate subject. Having entered into the 21st century, it is necessary to increase our understanding on plant immune systems and unravel the manipulation of pathogens. This will help to engineer transgenic crops with disease resistance and increased yields. Summary. Let us now recap what we have learnt so far. The occurrence of plant diseases have been recorded since the origin of organized agriculture. The incidence of dreadful diseases in plants attracted the scientists to study plant diseases extensively, and it emerged as a separate subject. The continuous advancements in the field have decreased the incidence of plant diseases, thereby increasing yields.